Hey, kujeni. Kujeni dakika moja tupige picha hapa. Uwe na katuata sura yake inaonesha na jefunga, sindio? Sura yake tu inaniambia amisa. He wants to be a policeman, and he wants to be a pilot. He wants to be a mechanic to repair vehicles. Yeah, but he said he wants to be a policeman so that every one of them can be afraid of him. It's really sad to see that still after 17 years, after still there's some boys just like I was doing the same thing that I was doing here that long ago. And I would want their lives to be changed, that's just as my life was changed. Yeah. When I think of when I was a small boy, I knew that I wanted to do great things. But something I also realized when I was just a small boy is that, yeah, my mom couldn't be able to give me all the things that I wanted to. So I only thought everything was just a dream. Yeah, and sometimes dreams don't come true. You just know that you want to do something, but yeah. It's impossible to do it.
My Pigs, it's a project that I started after my final year in high school. And the reason why I decided to do that is because I realized the burden was going to be big for my parents. And so my keeping the pigs there, I realized by maybe if they gave birth, I was able to sell them, maybe one, pay for the house rent for 2 or 3 months. Now the work with the pigs is quite easy because what I do is I go around the village picking waste food from the hotels and bringing to the pigs. Yes, it does work. Like for instance, the suit that I'm wearing now is from the pigs. I sold one for 2,500 Kenya shillings, and I bought this suit that I'm wearing today. And it has really helped because the house rent, my parents have never paid house rent since I started the project, yes. I want to become an economist. Basically, that has been my calling. The reason I like being an economist is because basically I will be able to one day advise the government on the policies. And I believe through it I would be able to make a difference in another person's life.
I know where I want to be, but there's a huge gap between my dreams and me. And for me to get to my dreams, they had to be a person. And that's where the LDP sponsor is and where the LDP program is. It comes and stands in the gap and makes a bridge for you to cross from where you are to your dreams. LDP is a program for youth. They can be sponsored to go for the studies in the university. And the special thing about LDP is that you not only get to learn about the course that you want to do, like for me, I did biochemistry, but you also get to learn about leadership skills.
Good. Things going well?
Yeah, well, things are going well. Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah.
So you're about to load something. An experiment, a PCR experiment?
Yeah, I did a PCR on nuclear receptors, on our THP1s. And okay. So I want to look at the expression of the nuclear receptors and see if they express all the nuclear receptors.
Als onderdeel van mijn onderwijs ben ik betrokken bij de Molecular Mechanisms of Disease. Dat is een masteropleiding. En daar hebben we een master opgezet die precies past bij wat we hier in dit gebouw doen. En dat is moleculaire levenswetenschap. En daar zitten dus dan in dit geval geloof ik 15, 16 studenten uit allerlei verschillende landen. En de achtergrond van Joshua was mij daar eigenlijk niet bij bekend. Later is dat wel wat gekomen, maar op dat moment toen ik hem voor het eerst zag, heeft dat eigenlijk niet meegespeeld op wat voor manier dan ook.
When I become an LDP student, that means that I gain more skills to become a better leader, of course a servant leader, and that means that I'll have good leadership qualities, and also I'll be in school pursuing a career, which I believe God will use me in a greater way. I'm Margaret. I'm 21 years old. I come from a family of three girls and my mother. My father passed when I was 9 years. It was really hard for my mom because she was unemployed. She's not educated and it was difficult for her. We believe that there's a future ahead of us. I'd love to become an LDP student, yeah.
Hi, Margaret.
Hi.
How are you?
I'm fine, thank you.
Tell me, how are you feeling today?
Good, but I'm having butterflies in my stomach.
Why? You shouldn't have butterflies. When the panelists ask you the questions, just speak from your heart. And when you speak from your heart, all that you want to be and all that you're envisioning for your future will come out without any struggle. Okay. So what are you going to pursue?
Actuarial science.
Actuarial science. Where?
Jequit.
Jequit. Okay. That's good. Wow, there are very few. There are very few in this country. You know that, huh? And you're going to make it. Great.
As a lady.
As a lady, yeah. I hope that as she goes through the interview process, she's able to convince the panelists that she has what it takes to be a lady and a woman of purpose.
I really need financial support. My family is going under financial constraints, and I realized by being the LDP, I would be able to realize my dreams. I have been preparing for this day for so long. I didn't do it for several days or several months. This is something that I've been doing for years. Yesterday, I was just meditating upon what I was going to do this morning, and I was just praying hard that God was going to see me through today.
This year, as Compassion International Kenya, we had close to 230 applicants. Unfortunately, we can only take 84. It is only the best that make it as final candidates into the LDP program. We would want all of them to join LDP, but they can't all join.
Ik ben zo'n 25 jaar, denk ik, al bezig met leiderschap. Daar schrijf ik over, daar train ik in, daar begeleid ik directies in. En ik ben betrokken bij het maken van internationale trainings- en opleidingsprogramma's voor grote bedrijven. En als ik dan zie wat Compassion doet met het Leadership Development Program, dan is dat zeer professioneel, zeer gedegen.
Stoel neem.
Dank u.
Als jouw mensen komen, dan zullen ze hier getraind gaan worden. En zullen we vooral gaan kijken hoe zij zeg maar, het leiderschap zo op kunnen pakken. Dat ze echt inspirerend en goed kunnen werken. Lijkt je dat wat?
Ja, prachtig om te horen.
Waarom ik een student wil sponsoren, is dat ik bij een student iemand heb die, waarmee ik op gelijkwaardig niveau kan communiceren.
Dat inrichten heeft te maken met processen, met het systeem, met de computer die functioneert. Afspraken die onderling maken.
Een student kun je uitdagen. Dus bij een student kan ik leider zijn, ik kan ondernemer zijn, ik kan coach zijn, ik kan vriend zijn.
Oftewel de actie die gepleegd wordt.
En dat raakt een snaar bij mij. Dat raakt een snaar bij mij als ondernemer, maar ook als mens, omdat ik zeg van hey, door wie ik ben en wat ik heb ontvangen en waar ik een stukje van teruggeef, kan ik het verschil maken in het leven van anderen. Ja, de student die ik sponsor is Davis. Davis is 22 jaar, studeert informatietechnologie. Als ik kijk naar Davis, dan zie ik dat ik voor hem het verschil kan maken door specifiek hem te sponsoren. Want zonder sponsoring zou hij niet uit de sloppenwijken komen. Zou hij ook zichzelf niet kunnen ontwikkelen tot een leider van het land.
Ja, John van den Nieuwel is from Netherlands. And he is married to Malik. John is an entrepreneur and then he has his own business. And yeah, that's what I know. For me, it is special that I am a student because I am from a humble background and I was lucky to get to NDP and then I was able to go to university. My dream for the future is that I will be able to graduate from university and then after that I will start my own company so that I will be able to get finances. Then I will be able to assist other students who are in the same situation as I am and then I will be able to improve my leadership skills.
My goal is to be one of the people who are going to get a vaccine for malaria. Even if my name will be just in small letters, I just want to be there on the list and then I'll have obtained my goal. I'll be really happy if that happens. My sponsor was a lady called Beth. Sometimes I just want for her to understand the difference that she made in my life. Like, if this is me right now after LDP, and this is the other person before the LDP, and just show her the difference, the two differences of this person.
Ik vind dat Joshua echt een hele veelbelovende student is. En ik zie zeker voor hem een mooie toekomst weggelegd. Waarbij hij uiteindelijk een verschil kan gaan maken. Zeker als hij teruggaat, wat een van zijn plannen is, naar Nairobi.
When I talk to my mom and my sisters, they're all excited to know that I'm going back to Kenya. I know they will all come to pick me up, so because they are all asking about the dates and the time that I'll arrive so that they can be at the airport. Smaklek, right?
It's Smaklek.
I can only wait for that moment of seeing all their faces and to touch them, to really know that they are still there, and to see them that they're healthy, so. I can still. I'm so excited about it. So excited.
David, how are you?
I'm fine, thank you.
Welcome.
Thank you.
Would you introduce yourself?
Well, my name is David Mushiri Waithaka. Mm-hmm. I come from KE 371, Korogosho.
Mm-hmm. What did you get at KCSE?
I got an A minus.
You're an A minus?
Yeah.
I'm nervous. I have butterflies in my stomach. In fact, I have a tissue roll here. But I know, yeah, I have courage and I'm confident that I'm going to make it.
My vision is to become an economist. That is what I have really wanted to become. And I think what the government really need is a policy advisor. Basically, economists are policy advisors. And maybe one day, as a policy advisor, I'd be able to sit down there courageously and be able to share my opinions on what exactly should be done to eradicate poverty in our society, to eradicate hunger from our society. And I felt that was really what I wanted to do. Thank you.
Ja, ik heb altijd marathon gelopen en veel gesport, maar zo'n paard is echt avontuur. Je weet niet wat hij doet. Hij doet het alleen als hij vertrouwt en dan gaat het allemaal perfect. En dat is gewoon heerlijk. Heerlijke vrijheid die je zo ervaart, maar ook om te kijken wat zit er in zo'n paard en wat haal ik eruit. Door een student te sponsoren geniet iemand mee van wat je hebt, wat je kunt. En niet alleen door het geld wat je erin stopt, door de studie die je mogelijk maakt, maar ik denk ook vooral door het ondernemerschap wat je aan hem verbindt. Laten we zeggen de coaching die je aan hem verbindt, het commitment dat je aan hem verbindt. En daarmee geef je hem of haar kansen, maar je geeft ook iets van jezelf.
Wat het in mijn leven verandert is dat je bewuster gaat nadenken over hoe je een verschil maakt, maar dat je ook merkt hoe je door in een ander te geloven daadwerkelijk kunt helpen om dat verschil ook te maken.
Fox, Wolf, kom. Kom. Fox, kom.
In het begin realiseren, het is gewoon een afstandsrelatie. Maar ga je Davis beter leren kennen, dan denk je, ja, maar ik wil die jongen zien. Ik wil hem ontmoeten. Dus ik heb me ook voorgenomen dat ik naar Kenia ga. En ik zie er echt naar uit hem te ontmoeten.
When I write to him, I tell him about my progress in school and my cousins, how they are doing. We talk about that. He inspires me a lot. For me, he's like a father to me. He mentors me and then gives me advice. I want him to be proud of me. I want to do my best, work hard.
Should I use this computer?
And then do good things. I want him to be proud of me. I want him to be happy and proud of me. I want to check if I have passed the exam, if I have passed to proceed with the next year. Okay, this one, number 54. 261-096, I'm Oriungi Davis, so I'm very happy. At least I passed all the units that I did, and I hope I did better. My sponsor is in Kenya. My sponsor has visited me. Yeah, they are in Kenya. So I want to buy a gift for them. Okay, you just tell me. Yeah, tell me. Yeah? I'm serious. Yeah.
Ja, ik vind het heel spannend, ook heel leuk. Ik voel me heel apart. Ik ben in de omgeving waar Davis is opgegroeid. Ja, dat is heel indrukwekkend om te zien hoe iemand die hier is opgegroeid gegroeid met zoveel ambitie aan een LDP kan deelnemen.
In the morning I had a positive self-talk. I looked at myself in the mirror and I said, Margaret, you're beautiful and you have a good smile and the panelists love you. They are ready to listen to you and you're going to say the right things. I'm Margaret Wambui Modoi. I like to study actuarial science. I like to be an actuarist. As you can see, I'm good in maths. I scored an A in my Form 4, my high school, and an 87. Yes, and an 87 in primary school. That was an A. So I decided to. Maybe I'm talented in that area. Maybe God wants me to study actuarial science. Mm-hmm. Yes.
We would really like to know their economic status. How do you take care of your bills? How do you stay? Where do you stay? That kind of thing. Let's get to understand your background.
When I was in class 4, my dad passed away, and my mother didn't have a job. She's a Form 2 leaver. So she couldn't get a job. And it was really hard for us. It was very hard for us. We went, we sometimes skipped some meals because my mother couldn't afford. But I thank God because of her. She's very hardworking. Anything which is, when she gets an opportunity, she works very, very hard. She's my role model.
Maybe finally just to, you know, we have asked you too many questions. Do you have any question for us?
Yes. I've seen the candidates and they all look bright and given a chance, they can make very good leaders. Mm-hmm. Why can't we have many sponsors so that all of us can be taken?
That's a good prayer.
Yes.
What happened is that one day my dad came home and then he packed everything that we owned onto a handcart and he took us to Dandora. Dandora is the dump site where every trash in Nairobi is thrown. Life was difficult, but now life became really, really hard. We're exactly where we used to live some 15 years ago when my dad sent us away from our home and he brought to a house that was exactly here and we lived here and then my mom thought that it wasn't really good to live here so she moved us away from this place. This is exactly Dandora. What I remember from this place is I can exactly remember the first day that we came here and it started to rain in the evening and then there was a lot of rain in the house and water inside the house and the water was coming through the roof and down and we couldn't be able to sleep and I think at one point we were all crying and wondering what is happening to us, what is happening to our family. That's one of the most difficult memories that I can remember from here. Yeah.
We carried the nyikiri. Nituana ready the kuizato. Nani go to shoka kuna dora itakatakaini. Idea one the dora imaratadini. Nindari nasia nasia the shukuru secondary. Kugu deikarite namutulero ali murito muno kenya genito ni high blood pressure.
She is telling me that around that time, what she can remember is that later my brother got a broken leg, and she had to take her to him to the hospital. But the government hospital had a strike, so she could only take him to a private hospital, and she didn't have even a single cent in her pocket. So what she did, she went around asking for money from people to try so that she can take my brother to the hospital. Then the other thing that she remembers is that there was a point that we didn't have food for 3 straight days without food. And it was really, really hard on her to see her children without food.
Thank you.
Yeah, it's a hard memory for her and for me too. Yeah, so. Yeah. For her to remember how she was unable to take care of us. Sad for her too and for me too. Look at this place, what can you do? There's nothing about education here. So LDP played a huge role in my life because I was able to go to the university to get educated, to get a degree. And it was such an amazing experience to go through the LDP because it doesn't make me still just a graduate, but it makes me a leader and a graduate.
Het feit dat Davis zeg maar nu een relatie is, een vriend, hij noemt hem zelfs vader, ja, dat zie ik als een geweldige bonus, want het is niet een ver weg sponsoring, het is gewoon een relatie die je aangaat en je ziet iemand ontwikkelen en groeien en daar heb je een kleine bijdrage in.
10 years from now, I will be getting my own money. I will be able to support my life. I will be able to sponsor the children, maybe the students who are from humble background. If I was not held myself, I won't be. I can't imagine where I would have been. I am waiting for that moment when I'm going to meet him.
Hij zal anders gekleed zijn, dus we zullen wel zien. Ik denk dat, dat er best wat emotie loskomt. Ik zal hem ook uitdagen op zijn ambitie. Hoe ver hij daarmee is, wat hij daarmee doet, wat hij nog van mij verwacht. Wat hij moeilijk vindt, wat hij niet moeilijk vindt. Ik denk dat ik als vader naast hem ga staan. En ik denk dat ik ook als coach naast hem ga staan.
Dat is hem. Dat wil hem wie? Sta jij maar eens op.
Ja. Dat is David. Good to see you, man. Goed.
taking my the goats that we are, they are going to be slaughtered today for my party. I'm holding a party for my friends, the friends who helped me to be able to come to the Netherlands. It's very difficult to control the goats. They are walking the way they want. We had to make a fundraising and everybody had to contribute some money. And my family is not a rich family, so when my sisters gave their money, and at the point I was coming here, they were left with nothing. And my mom gave all she had. By the time I was coming here, she totally had nothing. So it was like I carried all the money that they had just to come and study here. It will be a dream to just tell them thank you to for them to know that I appreciate for everything that they helped me to do, to accomplish.
Bistro Catteries. Kijk, zo'n ontmoeting is onbetaalbaar, omdat je iets sponsort wat ineens heel dichtbij komt. En dan ineens zie je dat de man die ontmoet, Davis, de jongen die ontmoet, de student die ontmoet, die heeft hier ook zijn droom en daar wil hij iets doen. En dat vind ik heel mooi om te zien en dat maakt mij nog enthousiaster om hem daarin te helpen. Bachelor of Science in Mathematics and Computer Science. They proceed to the third year. Congratulations. Yeah. So you are a smart person, huh?
Well done.
Yeah, that's very good.
Yeah. Yeah, I remember.
Ik wil zijn situatie niet veranderen, want wij leven in Nederland en hij leeft hier. Maar ik wil hem wel maximaal helpen om hier zeg maar iets te doen wat hij voor ogen heeft. Hè? Met zijn talenten die hij van God gekregen heeft te werken en daar ook daadwerkelijk het verschil te maken in zijn land.
It's just, for me, it just takes the hand of God and the favor of God to be in LDP. Everyone deserves because we come from challenge backgrounds. Almost all of us here, we come from challenge backgrounds.
If I don't get the LDP scholarship, I would be heartbroken. But then again, I believe God is going to be there for me, strengthen me. But I believe that I am going to pass the interview.
Good afternoon, students. Welcome and have a seat. I know you're coming to get your LDP interview results, which are out. In a moment, you're going to have your results. Just have a seat. First one is Bernard Onyango, Moiga Bernard, Maureen Wanjiko, James Jae, Waidaka and David Mushiri, and Margaret Wamboi.
Invitation to join Leadership Development Program. We therefore wish to congratulate you and further inform you that you are prepared to report for
I've passed.
I regret to inform you that you were not successful in joining the program. This in no way means you performed the worst in the interviews, but due to the high number of successful applicants, the committee had to use all available criteria to get the top 84 students as wait upon you to open other doors. Let the prayers that you find peace and reassure that all is not lost as he is watching over you.
Invitation to join the Leadership Development Program.
Be us my team through our academics. In Jesus' name, Lord, I worship you in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. Amen.
I just wanted to say thank you to everybody who was able to come and to help me to go to Netherlands. For me, it's a joy to see everybody here and to just say thank you. Because without your help, I wouldn't have made to go to Netherlands. I'm doing a research on malaria, so I'm working on a vaccine for malaria. So I know if I'm able to get the vaccine, I'll bring the vaccine back to my community. So it's a great pleasure for me. Thank you. LDP, still, I don't know where I would be still.
Wat je daarvoor terugkrijgt als ondernemer, is dat je misschien wel een droom terugkrijgt.
I see myself 10 years from now as a government economist.
I was very, very happy and it's like, for me it's more like a dream comes true.
I think I need some sunglasses. To see the future. I see a very bright future.